I'm sorry I haven't been around. It's been on my mind, but always work and life, you know? So I was looking through all photographs, and it's weird. All these years that I've known you, I find only the one photo of us from work together. Snap someone took. You're the exact same. I got all this hair, right? Like the darkest, blackest hair, like it's been painted on.
Thank you.
Do you want a bowl of something?
What, of cereal?
Yeah.
No, I'm good. So are you okay? You look all right, you don't look too bad. Maybe a little scruffier. It's one of the many benefits of being retired, I suppose. So what do you do all day in here? Do you read those books you always wanted to?
I watch television and drink a gin.
And that's it, you don't do anything else?
I walk around and try to locate the Twinkies.
So a little bit of exercise too.
Yeah, a little.
Don't you miss the business at all?
No.
Yeah, you do.
No, I don't. You want a drink?
It's 9:30, Mr. Newton.
Is it?
Yeah, it is.
Oh.
In the morning. 9:30 in the morning.
So late.
Anyway, I'm sorry it's taking me forever. I feel bad. No, I could swing by next week if you wanted it. I'd like to. You wouldn't mind me looking in.
I was sitting here in the middle of the night. And the television went off, and I saw something come out from the darkness, Michael. It's a scene I couldn't think about for years, and it came to me the way most things do in these pictures. It was morning time, and I was sitting at home with my wife and son and daughter. And nothing special happened, just small talk between us, I can't remember now. But I was there, at home, for a few minutes with them. It was cool.
You need to talk to someone. A doctor.
No.
But don't you remember the person you were your life outside?
That was before.
Well, it's gone. All of it.
Of course it's gone.
This isn't living for a man like you. Eating Lucky Charms, living on gin and fucking Twinkies?
There's nothing of the past. It left.
This is it now.
Right. So you never see her. You hear me, Thomas? Did you ever see Mary Lou?
Only in my head.
Thank you. she like?
Sort of sad. Sort of unknowable, the way you imagine reclusive, rich, eccentric men to be.
Sounds amazing. Is he good looking?
He's kind of freakishly young looking. Had a shitload of work done, I guess.
Oh, so you're attracted to him, obviously.
Yeah, my life is so starved of good-looking men, it would be impossible not to fall in love with him after 2 dates.
You slut. So is he with anyone?
Not now. He was once. He's lost. A little strange, too.
So it's just you. You and him is me.
His assistant.
Oh, his assistant. Right. You assist him. Got it. Well, I just want to know what my wife is doing at work. I think that's fair.
Just don't talk to me like that. Jesus Christ.
Like what?
My wife.
Well, fuck it, Ellie. You are my wife.
Yeah. You referred to me as my wife while looking in my face. My wife. This is my wife.
He knows that you're a wife, right?
Yeah. Yeah, I may have moaned about it once or twice.
What, in that wifey way? So, will you stick with it?
What, the job?
Yeah, do you think being an assistant will fulfill you?
I know you think my resume's been written by squirrels, while your love of information technology's been handed down from Moses. What, will it fulfill me, Zach?
Maybe it will. I hope it does.
Why'd you hope that?
Because I want my wife to be fulfilled. Obviously not romantically fulfilled with Thomas fucking Newton.
You know, maybe I'm romantically fulfilled with you.
Absolutely. I'm a very attractive man. And you're a beautiful and compassionate wife.
Yeah, I'm a terrible wife. When was the last time we had sex?
So what?
2 months ago, Zach.
It was 10 weeks, actually.
What area of my life have I ever been successful?
There are plenty of areas. Hundreds.
Give me one. I have to do something. I used to have dreams a long time ago, do you remember that? I used to have a sunny personality, now I'm a shitty pool.
Don't.
I'm gonna load the dishwasher, and when I return, I think we should try and have sexual intercourse.
Sounds good.
I'll probably need a sandwich first.
Yeah, me too.
Oh!
some help. Yes.
Do you know what happened?
Yeah, the floor hit me.
You should replace it with another floor.
Good thinking, I'll do that. You want a drink?
No, thanks.
Oh, a teetotaler. Right. So, what's your name?
I don't know.
You don't have a name?
Well, I must have a name, but I can't remember it just now.
You seem incredibly calm about that.
Yeah, I know, it's odd. You know, Quilts, you really look sick. You're not dying, are you?
A little bit every day. I'm a dying man who can't die, actually.
That's a joke, right?
Yes, not being able to die is a joke. A fucking terrible joke. Apologies for the F word.
You know, your apartment smells a little bit. Maybe if you got a scented candle or sprayed a little blade.
Sorry, but what exactly are you doing here?
Well, right now I'm talking to you.
No, you think you're talking to me.
What do you mean?
You're not real.
I feel real.
But you're... disappointment, but you're just another thought. A dream, a delusion, a chemical belch inside my head. Moments ago, Mary Lou was dancing inside that television, which is impossible.
What?
Thank you.
Yeah, a little. Who is he?
You already know.
You know everything about him.
I do?
You'll see.
So what do we do exactly?
There's a lot of showing up and listening.
They're all a bit messed up and tortured and stuff, but you fix things out for them and give them hope. Then you get to leave, once the work is finished.
He's a bit strange. You don't think I could work with someone else?
No.
Hi. I was gonna wait outside, but your neighbor, Mrs. Weisler, she suffers with insomnia. Well, she was outside of her apartment and she invited me into hers, which was really nice. We had a good conversation about insomnia, because I too don't sleep too well. You know, she prisoned me a little, but I prefer to be awake. Anyway, I pretended I was your brother and she gave me a spare cape.
Look, if you don't leave, I'm gonna call the police.
What, is that any way to treat a friend?
You're not my friend.
Fucking shit. Oh, the phone's dead. You gotta remember to turn off Bluetooth.
Look, if this is about money, I can write you a check.
My God, this is so unlike you. When we were kids, we were inseparable, right? And everybody presumed that we were brothers. And I stood by you when you told your family that you were a gay man. Do you remember all that?
What are you saying?
Well, all those people that we grew up with in Tinto Falls, they just turned on you. But I was there, in spite of feeling uncomfortable about your life choice.
No, look, this is just a stupid mistake, all right? I am not the person that you think I am.
Yes, you are.
No, I'm not. For one thing, I'm fucking straight. Now get the fuck out of my apartment!
You know, I don't remember ever being good to you, Mike. I never told you to F off. I didn't call you names. I didn't make a judgment about you. And now, I mean, you're acting like yourself out of this situation. Like you have already decided that I am not a good person, when actually, Mike, I am not altogether a bad person, you know?
Jesus.
I'm sorry, I'll go in a few minutes. I just give me a second to collect my thoughts. This is completely out of character, but this is just crazy. We apologize.
Oh, it's all right. Just take a moment. Let go.
I'm sorry, sir. Can I just sit down for a bit? I made the mistake of not eating today, or at least, you know, not eating very much. You know, I gotta remember to watch my blood sugar. I'm such a doofus about that stuff. This is a lovely part, by the way.
All the things that are my life.
you could help me find another Twinkie.
I think it's supposed to be help in the caring sense of the word, Mr. Newton.
Oh, like a very small nurse.
Yeah, maybe. I don't know.
So you know my name?
Yeah. You're Thomas Jerome Newton.
And what else do you know about me?
That you're not in my world. Which is a little weird, but true, right? Only a few people know that. You were sent here from another planet, and you never got back home to your family. You got real rich, started a bunch of companies. And then you tried to leave once before. But these people did experiments on you. And they hurt you really bad. Turned you crazy. And you wouldn't prove what you were to them, so they stopped you leaving. And you were in love with this woman called Mary Lou. But she left years ago. And you're still stuck here, drinking gin and not being able to die or leave. That's why you're headsick. You're heartbroken over all that stuff. I know your whole story, and nothing of mine.
What are you doing?
Oh, I'm sorry.
You have clothes of your own. I've seen you wearing them. But you're being paid.
This isn't your blouse, right? If it is, that's fine. If you want to do dress up in the safety of your own apartment.
It's not mine.
Right. So why'd you keep it? Just as a reminder of someone?
I don't need her things to remind me of her.
She's dead. You don't have to answer that.
I don't know.
So she just left.
A long time ago.
Did she love you?
Yes.
And did you love her?
So many questions in such a small amount of time.
I spent a summer doing market research for Macy's. I can ask 30 questions in under a minute.
Wow.
The only thing I have a talent for. So did you love her?
Yes. Very much.
Well, I think it's only fair you get to ask me a question.
Don't you have someone to go home to?
Yeah, I guess I have a husband.
Right. Then you should go.
What's it like to feel that much love for someone and to be loved back?
Yeah. Talking to
you. She's nobody, nothing.
I'll be back with reinforcements.
to stay the night, and I can't explain it. I don't want to go home. I'll keep out of your way. Is that all right? What's wrong?
I'm frightened.
Why?
When you're not here, I'm seeing you still. Others too. This man. If I haven't already, I think I'm about to break further.
Well, what can I do to help?
Nothing. It's too late. Stay if you like.
Thank you.
Thank you.
be the biggest name. You know, everything he touched turned gold. Now he's nothing. It's like he never existed.
It's amazing, really.
It's old, huh? You just found it? Tore it up.
You and your girlfriend, you're very good looking, by the way.
thank you.
Have you been together long?
About a year. Getting married in a week, actually.
Oh, congratulations. That's exciting.
Yeah. Oh, thanks.